Hello students, we have already learnt more about the rational numbers in the previous class. Today we have to discuss these two points, fraction and rational numbers and equality of the rational numbers. The first one is fraction and the rational numbers. Fraction. We have already learnt that a number of the form A by B is called a fraction, where A and B are natural numbers. So, 2 by 3 is a fraction. But, minus 3 by 7, this one is a rational number. So, what is the difference between a fraction and a rational number? The only difference is A and B in case of fraction is a natural number, while A and B in the case of a rational number is an integer. So this is the difference. All the fractions are rational numbers, but all the rational numbers are not fractions. You can take some examples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are natural numbers. Another one. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whole numbers. Equality of the rational numbers. Equality of rational numbers. Of rational numbers. We have a number 2 by 3. We can divide this 2 also by 3 and this 3 also by 3. The resultant number is 6 by 9. Again, we can divide, we can multiply. We can multiply this 2 by 3, the numerator, denominator both by 3 and 3. Again, 12. But where we will solve it, simplify it, again we will get the result 2 by 3. So, we can divide A by B by any number A into M, B into M. Again, A by B by N into M. In this way, to get the equal rational numbers. We can do the same. A by B, A divided by N and B divided by M to get the equal rational numbers. Now I want to discuss some problem from the exercise. Represent each of the following number on the number line. Represent Then add two decimal numbers. Add two decimal. Addition and subtraction of decimal numbers. Addition, subtraction and multiplication of the decimal numbers. We have to convert a decimal number in the standard form first, and then we have to add it as we have added it in the previous classes. So some exercises are given in the book. You can solve the problems. You can compare which decimal number is greater and which one is smaller. These very type of problems are given in the book. Some language problems are also given. You can solve it. The book is already loaded on the website. You can read it and solve it. And we will discuss the problems in the next class.